So, hello guys, I'm Dusty Dave, and I thought I would go at a Let's Play, and this will be on Thornton Farm. Now, you may have seen many of my other videos and realise I don't really talk. Well, the reason behind that is I don't have the best mic for doing this kind of thing, and I'm not exactly the most confident of people either. So, we'll give this a try. Hopefully you guys will like it. If not, I can always go back to the old way I used to make YouTube videos, I suppose. I've just already done this field here. I wanted to get this Let's Play off to a bit of a quicker start. As you can tell, got a little bit of money. And this is our equipment we have so far. So it's like the Massey combine, couple fent weights, seeder, couple trailers, baler, 939. It's not actually a 936. John Deere 6210. Couple of the Masseys out of Bullet Bill's pack is one of his trailers, and a water and milk trailer. Oh, and the stopping the automatic selling of the milk as well, so we can concentrate on doing that ourselves. So I think today we'll just finish off this field here, empty out the Massey combine, because this field is actually finished right now. I will try and do it realistically, but right now I'm just seeing how you guys will like the video, to be perfectly honest. I don't really play the game with anything other than an Xbox controller. I don't have a steering wheel or pedals or any of that, can't really afford that. So it's just the good old Xbox controller for me. Oh, that's that one empty. Move this one onto the next field in a bit. Nope. Oh, messed up. That's good. First video and I've messed it up already. Wow. This is going to set a trend. And just to let you guys know that I won't be able to do regular Let's Play videos. I work full time. But at the minute, work has been a bit up and down. So, if I do get a spare moment, I will try and do these videos. Although I have a daughter which is going to be 2 in August. So I might not have the quiet background to be able to do this. Or if you have a kid screaming in the background, I don't think many people would want that. Now, I'd like to bring up whilst I'm doing this, the subject of venting one estate. I know a lot of people have downloaded that map and want to play that map with friends on multiplayer. I have tried to sort the issues on there, but as of right now, okay, something typical. That's just about right, that is. Hang on a minute guys, I'll be back in a second. Sorry about that, typical that the controller dies. Oh, that's one brilliant model in the game that the Oxygendavid has brought in. That's why I like this map so much. It is one of the few that has managed to keep my attention, to be perfectly honest with you. Not many maps have actually done that. I think one of the biggest problems for me, talking and doing a Let's Play, is keeping talking. Normally by myself, quite quiet playing this. So, if I get quiet spots, don't worry, that's just me probably zoning out. I'll finish off baiting this field. I'll probably find this will be this is going to be a bit scary. This is a bit all over the place. I'll be talking about little bits here, little bits there, just due to the fact I'm new to doing this kind of thing. You know, I quite happily play the game, put my voice to a video. That is something different for me. As I was saying about Ventum Win, about the multiplayer not working, I have tried to fix it and it keeps coming up with object errors because I had to get rid of the composter so it would work in multiplayer. But then it raises errors. Multiplayer works, but it raises errors in the log, which FSUK are not happy with. So I'm not too sure on what's going to happen with Ventum Win Estate, to be perfectly honest with you. I mean, I could just leave it where it is. I know there's field definition problems and all that, which by the way is quite hard to do when you've got that many fields and different shaped fields. If you've got square fields, it's no problem. If you've got funky shaped fields such as the ones on Ventum Win, trying to get the definitions in them so they work properly as buy-in, so you can't just sow any old field, it is quite hard. You can still harvest fields which you don't actually own. It just, when it comes down to the groundworks and cultivating, sowing, ploughing, you can't do that unless you own the actual field. Which is kind of a weird thing. I'm not sure whether that's another error in the map or... I'm still learning the mapping experience, to be honest. I mean, my first map I publicly released was Willow Tree Farm in the mod contest, and that was a disaster. My first map I had properly ever created, I didn't have the right size PDA in it. There was errors for shaders. You know, I really didn't know any aspect of the game, changing names of the shop and changing different bits in the logs, stuff like that. I just didn't know any of it. Ventum Win was a massive learning curve, but in the meantime, whilst I was doing that, I managed to put out Pemberlin V2. I put that one out on FSUK, which is now like 5,500 downloads. It's a small map, perfect for single player. You can do multiplayer if you choose to. Although single player was more in mind for that, because playing single player, I find this map here isn't too bad. Everything's, the road layout's good and all that, but maps like Culper Park Farm and Ventum Win Estate and all that, you wouldn't really want to be doing on your own. You wouldn't get very far doing bits on your own on it. Well, you can do it. I mean, I did it. I was testing Ventum Win, apparently. Not too well. I didn't get a chance to test multiplayer, which is where the issues lay. Single player works fine, absolutely fine. But the multiplayer, that's a big letdown, because that's what I initially designed the map for. So people had a massive map they can do silage on, harvesting on, you know, whatever they wanted to do, you could do it. But unfortunately it hasn't worked out that way, which I am rather gutted about. Not particularly happy. I won't always tab to different tractors. If they're in the same field, I'll run across to them. So yeah, sorry guys about Ventum Win not working very well on the multiplayer. And what on earth has gone on here? Ah, this is just because I've just started the game up. Awesome tractor. Shame about that little start for when you got a loader on it. That's my edit, the 6210. Just a couple little bits, nothing major. change the sound, put a couple strobes on it, number plate in the window, change the number plate on the back, number plate there. Nothing major. I won't be handing out any of my edits. If you do notice a tractor which isn't publicly released, I'll try and find you the base model, but I won't release any edits. I don't believe in releasing edits of mods such as tractors and equipment. I don't think it's right when a lot more work, I reckon, goes into creating something functioning as a bit of equipment than a map. A map, if you got pretty good basics skills. No, I'm not saying it's easy to build a map, because it's not that easy, but a lot more, I would say, goes into building a bit of an equipment that works properly. Still at 96,000, so I don't think I'll sell any grain yet. Put this tractor away in the shed here, I think. I don't think there's any need for this one to be out right now. I've put the hardpoint trailer over here so we can change things with hardpoint. I don't want to go putting the workshop in. I don't actually know if this map has hardpoint built in. Not too sure. But if you follow my Facebook page, you'll know that I am currently working on a rebuild of Willow Tree Farm. And I've got a FS UK subject on it as well. There's not too much on there. People haven't taken as much interest in the rebuild of this map as when I started Venton Wynn. A lot of people seem to show interest in Venton Wynn. But the map has got the same terrain. There's little bits you will notice that are original in the original willow tree. But the whole map's had a complete and utter gutting, really. Such things as an actual road going through it now, rather than just the asphalt texture put through it. And I've used Thornton Farm as the base model for it, so you get all these nice new textures. Apart from the roads, I've kept the road textures I prefer. Although these do look very smooth textures in here, they're really nice, but I don't want to really go through the pain of going through all the files changing textures now. Not when the map's pretty close to completion. Got a few things that need doing on it, such as traffic, adding a few pedestrian splines, things like that. But the map's about 95% complete, I would say. I'll be releasing a video of some gameplay on that, of some forage, taking the forage harvester out, not the harvester, forage trailer, out to collect some grass for the sheep on there. So you see a good bit of the map. You don't get to see the main yard or anything. I've got a couple things that need sorting on that. But you do get to see a good bit of the map. Now I'm recording this on the 20th, and hopefully come the afternoon of the 20th I should have that Willow Tree video out, and hopefully this one, as long as audio and everything matches up, I can get it working fine. Then it should be two videos from my channel. I'd just like to thank everybody for the support on my channel so far. I'm nearly at 500 subs. That is quite unreal for me. I did it as a little side project thing, just an interest. I thought, right, I'm playing Farm Sim, might as well throw in a little bit more interest into it. So I thought I would add in a YouTube channel into it. It started taking off. And I'm hoping people are going to enjoy these Let's Plays. I will try to do a Let's Play on Willow Tree Farm, if people want it. If people want to see me play in the new map as a career mode before it's released, I will do that. I know a lot of people lately in the community have started hating people as people getting their maps early, like Daggerwin. You know, he did a preview on my Willow Tree Farm. Really thankful of that guy doing that for me. Put the publicity of the map out there a bit, and that's why map modders do it. They don't do it just to annoy the community that somebody's got the game first and they're putting videos up of them playing it. They do it so people become aware of the map. So when it's finally released, people are aware of it and they get the maximum audience from it. It's nothing to do with picking favourites or anything like that. That's one thing that the community doesn't really understand, I don't think. I have my own testers which I use and I trust for my maps. So if you message me asking to test a new map I've got coming up or anything like that, I say no or I don't respond. Don't take offence to it, it's just that I've got people who do test, and if I see somebody in the community that's been as well known in the community, you know, I don't want people that have been on FSUK for like a couple of days messaging me saying like, oh, you can trust me and that, because I don't know your work, I don't know if I can trust you. You know, there's a massive thing. You don't want all that hard work to be released prematurely. I hope you're liking this Let's Play so far. So see if you can write in the comments whether you, what I could change, what I can do just to improve. It'd be good. I will try and get more of these Let's Plays done, but as I say, normally I'm working full time and I won't have time to do things like this. So the videos may be few and far between, but they will get to you. Ooh, that was close. So yesterday I released gameplay on my channel, actually, of doing that first field. Which field is it? Field 13? I released footage of me harvesting it and baling it. And I actually got one guy commented on my video saying that I should talk and it'd be a lot better. And I got a couple people messaged me afterwards saying like I should do a Let's Play. They would like to see me do a Let's Play. So I cracked out the Turtle Beach because that is the only mic I've got. I thought I'd give it a go. Ooh. Just to let people know, I do have the dirt and terrain mod on this, but I decided to edit the file so if you drive over anything it doesn't damage it. It doesn't take it down to grass or straw or whatever it does. It doesn't do crop destroying. I did used to use the wheel lanes mod, but I did my head in as well. It's realistic, I'll give it that. But it's just an absolute pain. Especially when, I mean, I've made Venton Wind try to be as friendly with harvesters as possible through the gates and places, but you really cannot help when it comes to harvesting, driving through a bit of crop in the gateway. I know you lose a minimal amount, but it's still annoying the fact that you've got to get your header in there and you're destroying half your crop in the gateway. So I will be slipping on mud in this, but I won't be destroying crops. It's quite easy to edit the folder as well, just unzip it, go into, I can't remember which file it was called now, change it from true to false, and then that stops the crops being destroyed, but you still get the joys of slipping in the mud. Willow tree will have mud mod in it. I haven't had a chance to check it. I put it in last night, but I haven't had a chance to see if it actually does work yet. Just testing a few things out on it there last night, making sure triggers for animals and things like that work. All seems to be good so far. Couple errors in the log, but nothing that can't be sorted with just a couple changes of folders. It's got beef and pigs in it. It's got the water mod. It will have hardpoint built in, but that will be moved from where it is in the pictures to the industrial estate into a mechanics workshop. So you have to go to the industrial estate to get your trailers and skid steers and anything, any mod that's got hardpoint on it to change. Now, one thing I would like advice on when it comes to these Let's Plays is, is how long would you like them to be? Because I know people like Daggerwin and other YouTubers have problems with, they'll do a video 20, 30 minutes long. People say, oh, it's too short, it's too long. What would be the ideal length? I'd aim for between 20 to 30 minutes. That's what I would prefer. Keeps you entertained for long enough without it being too much. Oh, I think I'm just gonna leave these bales in the entrance to this shed and then shift them with the Massey and the bale fork later, because I don't think it's a very wise idea driving the auto stacker in any further than that. To be honest, there will be things done off camera, like harvesting whole fields. From personal experience, I get bored watching a whole field be harvested. I wouldn't want to do an episode of just harvesting a field. Now, this one's an introductory kind of episode, getting you to know me, I suppose. So, I think I'm going to finish doing this field off camera now. Leave a like and don't forget to sub. I hope you've enjoyed this video. And hopefully see you for the next one. Goodbye. See you again.